It is Friday. Now, Australia is a beautiful country, and one of the best ways to appreciate this great southern land is through the extraordinary photos of our next guest. Ken Duncan has many awards, including an Order of Australia Medal for his contribution to landscape photography. Let's welcome Ken Duncan. Ken, you have travelled across this beautiful nation of ours. I know this is a difficult question to answer. What's your favourite place?
The next place I'm going to, I think. I love so many places in Australia and so many secret places, like the south coast of New South Wales. A lot of people don't realise how amazing that is. So.
The amazing thing about the Australian landscape, and I was marvelled, we went all around Australia when I was a kid and it's never ever left me, but just the colours, the colours and the contrast are unlike anything you would see anywhere in the world. Do you find there's something, is there a quality in the Australian landscape that really doesn't exist, or is it all in our minds?
Look, it's the light. It's so clear, so clean. Yeah. You know, if you go to Beijing right now, you'll understand lack of light with pollution. Yeah. So it's a very clear light and beautiful light, so you get those beautiful colours.
We're looking at some of your images now. They are just spectacular. I want to know, do you ever take a bad photo?
Yes, but you don't get to see those.
Ken, what makes a good picture? I mean, I ask you because everyone's got a mobile phone these days. Everyone thinks they're a photographer, but that's not the case.
No, look, at a time when there's never been more photos taken, little is done with them. So you really need to do something like do a print or do a book or do something that's a permanent form. Because one of the reasons I did this book is a lot of people are going to lose their photos because they're not looking after them. They're on phones and someone loses the phone, they lose their photos. They're not backing up. So
it's pretty easy to do that now, isn't it? You can make archive stuff. You know.
I would say at least 90% of all photos taken now will be disappearing because they don't realise how to do that backup process with hard drives and blah, blah, blah.
And so, you still use film?
I love film too because it keeps you honest. And one of the things with these photos, you're waiting for moments. These are not Photoshop creations. Mm. These are just creation at its best.
You have to be really patient, don't you?
Yeah, just wait.
I think, as Ida was saying, is there a way that you frame it, or is there a time of day that you choose, or is there a special kind of trick, or is it just you've got the eye and no one else does?
No, everybody's got eyes. And everyone a unique eye. But the thing is here is trying to capture an image and create depth because you're doing a three-dimensional object with a two-dimensional camera. So you've got to create that sense of depth or create lead-in light.
That's
Tasmania, isn't it? Beautiful, you know?
I often look at your photographs, you know, because they're in certain select stores and so on, you know, and you look at them and it's almost like looking at a painting and you have to stop for a while and just take it all in because what you've captured is so beautiful.
Look, I really believe it's important to be connected to our land. And the thing is, we often get disconnected in cities. So my job is to go out in the bush and bring it back to people to remind them, oh, how cool's that place?
Look at that starry night.
I know, it's a beautiful
Milky Way
one. That's my favourite one, that one. And this is Montgomery Reef. You know, it's a shocking job I do, isn't it?
Where's Montgomery Reef?
Right up off the Kimberley coast. It's a wilderness and it's just... You know, photography is probably the largest growing art form in the world and people love it on their walls because it reminds them of where they can go to get away from...
To do these shots, do all your own research, you go there and scope out all the areas and really plan all these photographs.
I'm not sure. Really I may have a plan to start with, but I sort of lose that plan along the way. It's more of an adventure and it unfolds as you go, so...
Ken, I've had a quick look at your book. Thank you so much for joining
us.
These are absolutely sensational photos and they can be seen in his latest book called Chasing the Light Australia-wide, and it's in all wonderful bookstores around this great country. Ken, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me. Thank you. Merry Christmas.
And a great Christmas gift, that book.